This is a mic chest check. I've always been a painter. Textile is something that I found very recently. I've been painting since I was 16. I've been in art school since I was 16, specifically sort of more traditional figurative painting. But when I was at RCA, my final year, which was then interrupted by COVID, I had this massive artist block and I couldn't paint. Like, I made this one painting that I really loved, and all of a sudden it was like the lights turned out in my brain. And the only thing I could think to do, I'd made a quilt for my niece that summer. It was the first textile thing I'd ever made. First embroideries I'd ever done. I'd like embroidered her name into the quilt, and it was a patchwork quilt. And I just had so much joy just in doing the craft element and the, you know, flow and loss of time that came with embroidery was so different from the kind of engagement, this quick engagement I have with painting. So I started doing embroidery on canvas, and I approached it very much the same way I approach painting. My online presence and my artwork are very tied in the sense of how much I expose myself. My Instagram definitely became a place in the past several years to not just share this sort of stream of consciousness, like life experiences, which I think a lot of people do, but I often post like quite candid images of myself and my body on my Instagram. And part of that is this way to like normalize the way that I look for myself, but also for other people. And it also is this thing of agency. When I expose myself digitally on this public platform in the same way that I do in art, I have control over the way that I'm seen. Doing self-portraiture, and specifically doing this kind of portraiture where I'm, to the best of my ability, I'm not trying to present myself as anything other than what I am. There isn't like a conscious effort to be, for example, like sexy or appealing, like to thinking of the viewer in that sense. It's just, I'm trying to have this like one-to-one relationship with my body and to really understand it, because, you know, I grew up definitely with an element of body dysmorphia, and like seeing myself in images completely differently than what I learned later was reality. And to undo that distortion, I think painting myself has been really, really helpful, because I've become so familiar with my whole body. I've become so familiar with my face. I've become familiar with how like my breast lays on my belly. I've become familiar with like the wrinkles in my hands. Just like all these things that are just normal. Normal things about your body, but are particular to me. Horror did not explicitly enter my practice until 2-3 years ago, when I wrote my dissertation at RCA. Because at that moment, I finally was able, I've always loved horror movies my whole life. It's my favorite genre. Just like the escapism, but also the creativity and the metaphor and just like everything present in horror, more so than other genres, has been something I've really lived for and loved. But that dissertation that I wrote, it finally clicked in my head that I can use the iconography and language of horror that I've become so familiar with my whole life to talk about these experiences of mental illness, abuse, like body shame, body like weirdness, like the feelings that we all possess. And I can use things like haunted houses. I can use things like the sort of mystery assailant that's all present in a lot of these slashers. And also, you know, I think there's an interesting thing of the final girl, if we want to talk about the presentation of women, where it's a person who is victimized and abused who then becomes, you know, the powerful element in the end of the film and either escapes or overcomes the threat. The one artist that I would definitely say I think about a lot is Artemisia Gentileschi. I'm so gutted that I wasn't able to see her show because of COVID in London, but when I first learned about her in college and learned about how not only was she just like incredible female painter in the Baroque period, when there's like definitely some female painters, but mostly not, and they certainly didn't get the respect or attention they deserved. But the fact that she went through this horrific trauma with the rape of her tutor and then made all of these paintings where she inputted her own image as these different biblical historical heroines, and like really candidly and honestly depicted herself and women as a whole. Because you compare the way that men were painting, you know, Susanna and the Elders, or Judith and Holofernes, and it's so different from the way that she was describing it, because she was bringing her personal experience to it. And this was before I started making self-portraiture, but I just found that to be really powerful, that she was able to take her lived experience and live through these paintings. And I definitely think she's someone who just really moved me.